Alright. So, what's this?
Mr. Boyd, I feel bad about coming to you again, but you're really the only one who can help with this. I hate that we have the background with the words because it makes the words so much harder to read. Those records that my ex sued me for, well, I got them back, of course. And I guess this could be nothing, but her big-nosed brother had his sights on them. The idiot even hired a private detective who's been at my store 3 days straight. Now he has the audacity to come to my house and accuse me of being involved in the record's disappearance. I don't know how he has any evidence, but the risk is just too high. Can you scare them both and make sure they stop poking their noses into other people's business? My store is open for you anytime.
So it does sound like you went and you stole the records back. I understand that they're your records, but you still fucking sold them back. If I can just send one officer, I will. And I can't. You require three. You're low man on the priority list. Let's see, suspicious individual. Former psychiatric patient, Leboko Clark, called the police because a maniac was harassing people at the mall. According to Leboko, there's a killer on the loose who will stop at nothing. I would rather send three people to that than to help that guy. Maybe I'm a bitch. Feel free to fucking call me a bitch in the comments. I don't care. And I still don't have three available. Sorry, dude. If I could just send two, I would, but it won't let me. And I'm not about to sacrifice three cops for your bullshit. The suspicious man... No, sorry. The man's suspicions were aroused by a shopping center employee wearing a costume. He was dressed as the hero from the movie Dressed in Blood. He was pretending to menace visitors as part of the fun, but he wasn't going to kill anyone. So maybe I should have sent three people to that guy. Oh well. So we now have three people, plus we still have the SWAT team and the paddy wagon, and oh, there's three more. We shouldn't have too much of the day left. Yeah, there we go. God. That was a slow night. So four and four. Alright, day 15. Mayor proves his commitment to nepotism. City police chief not elected position, says Mayor Rogers. Mayor Rogers, if my nephew wants to lead the police, I support him. Yeah, that's not fucking good. I'm sorry, but there... To get to the head of something, you should have some... Wait, today they're offering free admittance to all the museums in the city. I'm a big fan of art. Can I have the day off? Yes, but come in tomorrow because you're the lead on a case. I'm too tired. I can hardly walk straight. Can I go home? Yes. I drank too much and I don't think I can hold it together today. Can I go home? Yes. Mikey's been causing trouble again and they've called me to his school. Can you give me some time to deal with this? I'm sorry, dude. I've already let two people go. It looks like the janitor hasn't been around to clean the toilets today. I don't know about you, but I care about the cleanliness of my intimates. Can I go home? No. So, let's give it to... Can I give these guys stripes? There we go. Well, I might as well buy what's left. I like this. I hope you guys aren't getting tired of this song. This tune, whatever you want to call it. I like it. There's the funeral. So, hire female cops. Considering certain recent events, we are obligated to grant some concessions to the feminists. You are to make sure that at least half of the staff at the police station are women. Well, fuck, I don't know how many... So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and I'm guessing staff includes the detectives, so 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 women, and that's it. So, let's ask for an additional officer slot again. And it's not like there's even enough. All the detectives' slots are filled. But there isn't even enough women here to cover all the spots that I would need. Let's see if I were to fire him. Came to work drunk. That guy... It's not the first time he's come to work drunk. So, I'm going to fire him. And then this is for shift A. And then I will hire female. I would rather not fire him, and the only reason why you would fire him is that he's too old. So there's... Nope. He's too old, he calls out fairly regularly, and he's not that great. So we're gonna fire him, too. I would rather not fire him. Is there good? There's no legal reason to fire him. No legal reason to fire him, either, although he makes a lot of fucking excuses. Nope. Okay. And then... He hasn't really served a purpose anyway. And then... Pretty sure... Okay. So, then we need one officer and one detective. So we will hire... Let's see, I fired two people from the A shift, so we need another person for the A shift. And then it was the B shift detective that I need. Okay. So that should be good. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 men. And then we will have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 women. That should work out in our favor. Okay. Okay, so let's just kind of hope for the best with that. Alright, suicide threat. A taxi driver heard someone screaming and noticed a few people gathering on the bridge as he was driving past towards the port. He stopped to see if anyone needed help, but as he approached, he saw a man was threatening to throw himself and two children into the water below. Jason left us. I lost my job in the house, and there's no way we'll survive. It's better if everything ends now. To the taxi driver, it looked like suicide. You think? Alright, there's children in danger, so that needs to be handled. Alright, an elderly man speaking in a raspy whisper just reported a break-in. There's someone in my house. They're pounding on the door and marching all around downstairs. Hurry. We'll send two there, although I get the feeling that that might be a false alarm. Alright, two tearful boys, clearly in a state of shock, are standing dangerously close to the edge of the bridge. Beside them, their drunk and distraught father is slowly pushing the children closer to the precipice. Don't worry, don't be upset, my friend. Tell me about your wife. Don't be upset, my friend. Tell me about your husband. Considering he said, Jason, I'm gonna say husband. A strong gust of wind almost blows one of the children off the bridge, but he recovered at the last moment and stumbled to the ground with a scruff of the knee. Rest of the child's aid. The man slurs his words, saying there's no point in delaying the inevitable. Your children have their whole lives in front of them. You can't make this decision for them. Point a gun at the man and order him to step away from the- Well, he's trying to commit suicide. What the fuck does pointing a gun at him do? Think about what you're doing. There's people who care about you. I mean, it's cliche, but this is my best answer. Yes! Alright. Disorderly conduct. Secretary Abigail Jones told the police that her boss, Marlon Quebec, returned from a meeting in quite a state. When he entered, he took a bag of white powder from the safe and shut the door. Now he's yelling incessantly and making a scene, demanding that his secretary deliver him the head of a unicorn, or he'll cut her throat with a letter opener, and then go after the rest of her family. I wish I had more officers, because he's clearly high on cocaine. Alright, let's see, young drunken biker broke into a church and rode around between the pews, defiled the sacred crucifix, and fled the scene. That reminds me. Details. Like, we clearly need four. Alright, the disorderly conduct got away. Fuck. I got the cocaine, but I'm pretty sure that secretary was just killed. There's no one except the dogs in the house. They were scratching at the door because they wanted to go outside. Let's see. A member of the family was out at a restaurant having dinner with his secret lover, but because the affair was secret, he was light on protection, and one of Varga's agents was able to slip a grenade into the room. This is a job best handled by the police, unofficially, of course. So long as they don't tell me to ignore crime, I don't mind it so much. So how do I handle it when there isn't, like, okay, yeah, let's put, there we go. See if maybe we can generate another grouping or something, another picture, maybe. I don't know. I don't know how that works, because I didn't get enough pictures, so I can't, like, solve the crime, really? So I'm kind of confused as to how that works. Excuse me. Oh, God. Gone. A man wearing a suit walked into the lobby of the bank, locked the doors, and proceeded to kill several customers. He never said a word. He just started firing at people, reported one eyewitness. A dozen people remain inside the building, and the criminal's demands are as yet unknown. Anytime there's, like, a mass shooting, you need the SWAT team. So, I have those two guys back, plus still the paddy wagon, so hopefully we should be able to handle the next call. Alright. Let's just send everyone. And then whoever happens next, like, they're fucking screwed, because this is, yeah. A sweet girl named Anna is one of our key assets in a large accounting firm. She just got home from work and found the house was on fire, and the assholes that started it are still standing around admiring their handiwork. Wouldn't it be pretty if someone cracked open their skulls and tossed them onto the flames. Only if I can get people back here fast enough. Holy shit! Well, the civilians were unharmed, at least. Jack, keep up the good work, and we'll make sure your final days here. Okay. They can come back in time. I'll send these two. And in the meantime, I need three officers, and I'm not allowed to yet. I would prefer to report the deaths, even though I could still collect their paycheck, because I need the bodies to fight. Destruction of property. Okay, open investigation. But this requires several. So, again, I am fucking confused. Ha! Okay, so not all of these will work. So, wait, that just shows them. No. Go back. Okay. Ugh. Alright, I'm gonna just play around a little bit and see if I can get this to work. I will be right back.